Hello everybody and welcome back to my channel. Today I wanted to talk about Kryolan's eyebrow forming gel. And in order for me to talk about it really, I wanted to compare it to my personal favorite, my ABH brow freeze. And so if you're interested in that, please keep on watching. Okay, so I went ahead and I picked up the Kryolan forming gel, mostly because, you know, when I think about Kryolan, I always think about like hardcore, you know, hardcore makeup, or if you wanted to do some kind of fantasy thing, you might want to pick up their multi-colored foundations or just, you know, just different things that they have. But I haven't really tried anything outside of that. So when I saw the forming gel, I thought that that's actually something that I can use. And I wanted to go ahead and compare it to my current ABH brow freeze. And I wanted to compare it to the brow freeze, which I know I absolutely love and works for me perfectly well. And so let's go ahead and do that. So I have done my eyebrows. And I just need to go ahead and set it with something so that they stay up. And on my left hand side, I thought that I would go ahead and use this. Now it's in a typical wand. Smell doesn't have too much of a scent. I was expecting it to have more of an alcohol type scent, but it doesn't. But let's go ahead and apply that. It applies really lightly. I could barely feel it, and it almost feels like I don't have anything on my eyebrow. But I do. So right off the bat, I can tell you that it does seem to be holding pretty well. It's very light. It almost reminds me a little bit of hairspray, but yeah. Now, what I don't like about this right off the bat is that I have to go ahead and stick it back into the tube. Now, the reason why I don't like that is because I find it pretty disgusting. I mean, to actually use something that has touched my skin, or to use something that I know I've put makeup on, because I do have product on my eyebrow, and then having to put it back into the tube, because it just screams bacteria to me. Now with this, what I usually do is I grab a little bit. Okay, so what I like to do is I like to grab a little bit with a spatula and just put it on the back of my hand. And from there, I will go ahead and use something to apply it with. I have this old, tiny little brush that I kept. I usually keep most of my brushes, and for reasons like this. You never really know when you're gonna have them come in handy. I like to use my old mascara wands for applying my hair dye. So I pretty much keep most of my brushes and wands. Okay, so comparing it right away to the brow freeze, this definitely is more of a gel type consistency. As you can see, it is thicker and it definitely holds my eyebrows however I want them. Much nicer than the Kryolan. So far, I'm thinking that the Kryolan is doing okay, but not fantastic. Hey, who knows? Maybe at the end of the day, I'll change my mind. So yeah, I'll go ahead and wear this today and I'll check in at the end of the day and see how exactly they look. Who knows? I may have a new favorite. Who knows? I'm back and it's the end of the day and I think my eyebrows are doing pretty okay. on my right hand side, I have the brow freeze, and on my left hand side, I have the forming gel. So let's take a look really quick and see how it's doing. And I have to say that they're both doing pretty well. The brow freeze still looks pretty darn good. Almost as good as when I first applied it, and pretty much can be said about the Kryolan's forming gel. It definitely does look pretty good. Now, just some quick facts regarding this. This right here is $34, which I think is really expensive for a gel. And I mean, you might want to keep that into consideration. I believe that this was $23, so there's quite a big difference in price. I think that they both pretty much work the same. Big differences is that the Kryolan side feels almost a little crunchy, or, you know, very stiff, the way that a really super stronghold hairspray would feel. And this side feels a little bit sticky still, so it probably, if you had to, you could probably still play with it a bit. Also, I was reading on the website, and regarding the Kryolan, they recommend this on men's eyelashes. So if you want to stay to the end of the video, I'm going to do a really quick trial in the morning, tomorrow morning, before I go to work. And I'm going to use them on my eyelashes just out of curiosity to see how they actually do work. And you never know. I mean, I might like it, but I think I'm not going to say I won't, but I probably won't, because I do like the darkness of the black on my eyelashes. But we'll give it a try just out of curiosity. I think that it does pretty well. It's a little too pricey for me. I think that it probably is something I'm not going to be repurchasing, because I think that there's other products out there that cost less and that work just as well. This does work very, very well, or this does work very good, but it's a little too pricey. And like I said, I don't really like this type of wand inside of the tube type of thing. I just, for sanitary reasons, it's not my favorite thing. You know, I don't even like doing it with mascara, but that really doesn't, I really don't have much of an option unless I want to use some type of cake or something like that, which I really don't want to use. So yeah, that's so far my review on eyebrows, and I hope you enjoyed this. And please leave a comment, consider subscribing to my channel, and I'll see you tomorrow morning. And if not, thank you for being with me anyways, and ciao. Hello everybody, and good morning. I just woke up a little while ago, and I did my face routine, my morning face routine, and I just have sunscreen on, and I did add a little bit of color to my eyebrows. So that's pretty much all I have on, and I am ready to try on this Kryolan eyebrow forming gel on my eyelashes. It says that a pro tip is that you can use this on your eyelashes. So I wanted to try that just out of curiosity to see what it's like, if it's kind of like a waterproof mascara, or we'll see. I wanted to also note that yesterday when I was taking off the brow product or all my makeup, this was extremely difficult to take off. I used my oil-based cleanser, the Take the Day Off by Clinique, and it was not coming off my eyebrow. My other side came off fine. Even my waterproof mascara came off fine, but it just was not coming off. So then once I used my lotion wash, then it started to come off a little bit, but it really took a lot of work. So this, for that reason alone, I'm not really interested in buying it again. Okay, so I'm using it on my eyelashes and I see that my eyelashes are already starting to fall. I had just curled them and they're starting to fall. Well, that's a bummer. I thought that at least, if anything, it would give you a natural look and have them stay up. But nope, it's starting to fall. And there they go. Well, this is an epic fail for me. We tried. Ciao.